Hey, folks, we're in Toronto, and we're at the Lift Expo, and we're with my good friend Claude
from Manatus Bioprotection. How you doing, man?
Super great. It was an amazing expo. We've done a lot of contacts. We met a lot of people that were going to help a lot with all our solutions against their bugs in our gardens.
Cool.
If you have a problem with spider mites, with trips, with aphids, root aphids, rustin mites, every bug, I think, that attacks cannabis, we have a solution for.
Cool. What's that behind you?
It's a green lacewing larva.
Right.
It's very impressive. People think it's the bad guy, but no, he's the good guy. He's eating the aphid right now.
Oh, yeah.
The aphid.
And we chop him down.
Exactly. And you could see in this little cage, you could see the adults are flying around the green lacewing. They call them the lion of aphids.
Okay.
So that's just one of the solutions we have against aphids.
Cool.
We have different solutions for different problems.
What do you got for spider mites?
We have Neocilius phalacis here.
Yeah.
It's a very good preventive. You add them to your garden when you start, and you're going to fend off any invasion of spider mites.
Right.
And Persimilis is the most known. He is good in cannabis, but he needs 60% humidity to lay its eggs. So it's not best.
Not for flower.
So not the best solution when you're in flowering.
Right.
He's good though to take rid of. He's the only one that goes across webs, that walks across webs.
Oh, that's handy.
So that's what, and he's very voracious. So you put them in hot spots, and what I do is I do a power team with somebody else.
Yeah.
Stetorus. Stetorus is our own unique. It's like a tiny beetle.
Okay.
He eats a lot of spider mites.
Does he eat the eggs too?
Exactly. And it flies to the spider mite, it smells them.
Yeah.
It goes and lands just next to the spider mites, starts to eat a couple eggs, then lays its own eggs.
Right.
And once its eggs, the larvae emerge from the eggs, they go crazy and eat everybody around.
Perfect.
Yes, exactly. And what is very efficient about is that it works between 30 and 90% humidity.
Awesome.
So it's very versatile. We got also Californicus. We have them in bulk or in small, slow-release sachets.
Right.
Sachets are, they look a bit like that. They're like tiny breeding farms. They have 100 individuals, a couple of hundred individuals that will become thousands over 4 to 6 weeks.
Right. You just hang that on the bottom branch?
Yeah, you hang them with a hook or you plant them in the ground next to the stalk of your plant.
Okay.
And they slowly come out of the sachet, go up the stalk and go inspect your plants and guard your plants. So we have the solution. Californicus, and we have Cucumeris for trips.
For trips, this is handy.
And the same thing for the Cucumeris, we have the small, slow-release sachets that you hang on your plants or you plant in the soil.
And trips destroy.
Exactly. And you have a lot of trips already, and you need another ally that's going to eat the adult trips. Aureus is the way to go.
Cool.
For fungus gnats, we have nematodes.
Okay, nematodes, that's right there. And that'll destroy all the fungus gnats.
Exactly.
Cool.
And we have also other solutions for fungus gnats. We have Stratolelaps, which is another predatory mite.
Okay.
Very, very efficient against fungus gnat. Root aphids too, and other soil-dwelling pests. Galilaps also, another friend. And Dalosia too. Dalosia is very particular. It climbs, it flies, it digs in the soil, it walks on the leaves, it's aquatic, it swims.
Yeah.
People even buy them to clean drains. We use them in deep water culture systems, in aeroponic systems, in hydroponic systems.
Really?
They go everywhere. They go either in cocoa soil. Its other name, most known name, is the rove beetle.
The rove beetle.
Yes, exactly.
Very versatile beetle.
Exactly. And if you have other solutions against aphids, we have Aphidoletais. But this little guy, if it's more, it's less than 14 hours of sunlight, he's going back to sleep.
Oh.
So you only use them in vegetative.
Yeah, it's good for the bedroom.
Exactly. Here we have the brown lacewing. The advantage of the brown lacewing is that the adult also eats the aphids.
Yeah.
Contrary to the green lacewing, that's only the larva that eats the aphids.
Okay.
And the brown lacewing is very good for people that have greenhouse outside because it works between 4 and 32 degrees Celsius.
Holy smokes.
So it's very versatile for that. Here, the most known, the ladybugs. They're seasonal. They're available in June, they start. But it's for a greenhouse, I would advise, for indoor grow, not really, because they tend to go burn themselves on the bulbs. So it could be a security issue.
And the fans.
Exactly. Yeah. They go in the fans too. So it's not the best solution. It's the most known. But for greenhouse grow, yes, but not for indoor, I wouldn't recommend the ladybug.
Okay.
And there's another friend, Aphidius. Aphidius is a parasitoid wasp. It goes lays its eggs inside the aphids.
Oh, no way.
And we, how we do it is that we have a banker plant over here.
Yeah.
It's either oats or wheat that we grow. Yeah. It's infested with grain aphids. The grain aphids only the grain. This becomes a mini farm for Aphidius. So you just set up one of these containers in your greenhouse.
Yeah.
You introduce Aphidius, and then it maintains itself. It's a little farm for them. So cool. It's their like base, home base. They go from here, and they leave, and they go scout the greenhouse to find the aphids.
They start munching them down.
Exactly. And here, these are insects that we can use for different problems.
Right.
But we have our own biopesticide. It's a microfungus called Bovaria bassiana. And it's a powder, wettable powder, liquid formula coming in August.
Cool.
Approved by Health Canada for cannabis production.
Oh, that's really important.
We're one of the 22 products that's approved by Health Canada, but we have another product, another strain of Bovaria on the market, but we are the only one that's certified organic by EcoCert since 2015, listed the OMRI. So we're organic, approved by Health Canada, and the powder itself, or the liquid, it attaches itself to, you spray it over the insects, aphid, very efficient against root aphids. A big problem right now in cannabis, root aphids. White flies, trips. Right now we're testing it against spider mites because other European companies have other strains of Bovaria and they claim it's good against spider mites, but we had to validate through our own testing. So this year we're going to see how efficient it is for spider mites too. And the thing is, the powder itself attaches itself to the skin of the insects. It germinates inside them and kills them off.
Wow.
The product itself degrades in about 24 hours under light, so there's no residue left. So for extraction purposes, for analysis, you pass all the tests because there's nothing left. It all degraded. All the spores are gone.
That's awesome.
So it's a real good solution for especially by trips, aphid, root aphids, and white flies. It's less common in cannabis, but it can happen.
Cool. How many bugs have you got all together?
I would say more than 30 bugs, and we have many new ones coming in the future, new products we're working on, new ways to improve. I'm head of the cannabis division now at Anatsys, so we're working on a lot of projects. We want to use a lot less vermiculite than we used to for the carrier for the insects.
Okay.
So we use bran now. We use other substrates. We're looking into using some mylitols, things like that. So things that will degrade, that won't be harmful to leave any residue in the crop, you know.
Also,
one important thing I have to say, prevention is the key.
With
biological control, we can cure problems, especially if we want to save your mothers or things like that. You had an infestation of whatever bug, but prevention is the best. And we never advise to put any bugs. We don't introduce any more bugs, or we use Bioceres until 6 weeks before harvest, because we don't want to introduce bugs. If you had a problem, you had to take care of it before.
That makes sense,
And we don't want any contaminants in the weed. But most of the insects will cannibalize each other, or die off, or walk away. You won't find them in your crop anymore. But 6 weeks before the end of harvest, we don't put anything anymore. You have to take care of the problem before. So prevention is the key.
Yeah.
So ask people, LPs or small growers, or you have security for your grow, your installation, but you have security for your plants. That's what we're offering at Anatsys Biotech.
Cool. Claude, if somebody wanted more information about Anatsys, where would they go?
You visit our website, anatsysbioprotection.com, all in one word, A-A-N-A-T-S-Y-S. natisbio.com.
Okay.
You visit our website, tons of information, videos, lots of happening. You can find us on Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and on Twitter too. So we're all over the social media, and you're gonna find us at all the major Canadian cannabis expo now.
Awesome.
We ship across Canada, 24-hour express, with Purolator or FedEx, in an insulated box, like that. So you receive your package at home, guaranteed to arrive fresh and ready to fight at your place. We sell online. There's no small grower. We help people with a small closet to the big LPs that have hundreds of thousands of square meters.
Big or small, it doesn't matter.
Exactly. We help everybody. And we even offer IPM solution, integrated pest management system. So you write us, you tell us what is your grow. Is it living soil, deep water culture system,
yeah,
hydroponic, cocoa, whatever. Is it indica sativa hybrid, greenhouse, box in the box, whatever.
Yeah.
If you had an history of problems before, and then we'll calculate the cost per square meter from start to finish of all the problems you have to prevent in your garden. Also, before I forget,
yeah,
for people that can grow cannabis outside or hemp farmers,
yeah,
there's a lot of corn borer problem. Corn borer is a caterpillar that goes inside the stalk of corn, potatoes, and now hemp and cannabis. It loves that plant. I met some hemp farmers 2 days ago that lost half their crop to the corn borer. They had no solution. We have the solution now. Trichogramma wasps, they're parasitoid wasps. They come inside this card. This is what it looks inside the card. There's about 4,000 to 8,000 eggs on this little dollar size circle.
Yeah.
And what it does is that you hang the card in the field, and the Trichogramma wasps will emerge from the cards, and they will find the corn borer eggs. They will lay their eggs inside the corn borer eggs,
yeah,
and kill them.
That's awesome.
So this is the old school method of application. You go in the field, you apply it. But we're finishing testing this year with drone dispersal.
With a drone?
So with the drone, you set up your drone, program it, fill up with the capsules full of a Trichogramma wasp.
Yeah.
You set it, let it go over your field, goes and drops all the capsules over your field. So it's going to be the way of the future. It's going to be so cheap. You're going to do all field, all big fields of hemp are going to be protected against the corn borer that way, in a natural way.
That's awesome.
And all our insects are non-invasive species. They're all native. They're all made by us or with our Canadian partners. And that's what makes us stand out too. They're not refrigerated from another country like two competitors we have,
yeah,
shipped overseas. So all Canadian by us, made by us here.
All and Canadian with our
exactly, with our Canadian partners. So it assures also the quality and the efficiency. And we have a good quality control by Dr. Saint-Onge and our team about all the insects we rear ourselves and all the ones we get from our Canadian friends.
That's awesome.
Exactly.
Awesome. Well, thanks for talking with us.
Yes.
You have a great product. I want to try it myself.
Perfect. So visit us online at anatisbioprotection.com. You can order online. You'll be satisfied with our project.
I'll order some for sure. Oh, Claude, do you know what time it is?
Time to smoke a good joint.
Indeed, it's time to smoke a huge joint. But in the meantime, keep watching Urban Rainbow for more coverage of Lift.